I should understand that. Okay, even though I've never seen David in my life, I know he's still my brother. I gotta have love for you. But we've been taught to hate each other here in this country. Why? Because everything that we've learned since the time we came out of slavery, especially here in Charleston, South Carolina, has been against us. We've learned to hate each other during slavery. Hello, people. We are Israel United in Christ. We come to teach our people, you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians, who you are according to the Bible. Why you are oppressed here in Charleston, South Carolina? Why we are oppressed all over the earth? And who we are as the chosen people of the Most High God? Give me John 8:32.
John chapter 8, verse 32. Yeah. And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
See, we think we're free here in Babylon the Great, also known as America. The Bible says that you're going to know the truth, and this truth that you're going to know is going to set you free. Free from being fed by your enemies. Free from being slaved by your enemies by working on their plantations, right. Working on their jobs, asking for handouts. If you want true freedom comes from the Holy Bible, which you have not learned in your whole life. Right. Read it again.
John chapter 8, verse 32. And ye shall know the truth.
The Bible says that ye shall know the truth. Come on.
And the truth shall make you free.
The truth shall make you free. Not handouts from your oppressor. The truth of the Bible is what sets us free as a people. Right, giving the truth. All right? But we haven't been taught the truth. We think the truth is wake up early Sunday and go to the park so that we can be fed by the same people that caused us to be in the condition that we're in.
Whoa.
The Bible is the truth. Your heritage, your laws, your land, your language, everything that God gave you is in the Holy Bible.
Yeah,
come on.
Right. Psalm chapter 119, verse 142. Yeah. Thy righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and thy law is the truth.
The laws of God is the truth. Now we stand in this park in the midst of two or three churches, but our people don't know what the truth is. Come across the street, brother, I see you. Our people don't understand what the truth is. Our sister over here playing with her children. She doesn't understand what the truth is. But these men that you see standing before you today, we come to teach you what the truth is and who you are according to the Bible. God calls you the Israelites, his chosen people, the people that he chose above all people on the earth. Read it again.
Psalm 118, 142. Thy righteousness is an everlasting righteousness.
He said that his righteousness is an everlasting righteousness. Come on.
And thy law is the truth.
God's law is the truth. All right? What is a law? The laws of God. I got a question for you, brother. What does the laws of God provide for our people? Do you know? Here in Charleston, South Carolina, what are some things that we can be doing better in our community, but it just seems as though we cannot move forward? All right? All our lives, we've wondered why we're in this condition. Why is it that we're the people on the bottom? In all of society, and everywhere you go across the earth, why is it that you can look into any ghetto, in any community, and only see our people in the lowest condition? Why is that? Why do you think that is, brother? What's your name?
I'm David.
David. My name is Kalai. How you doing? How you doing, David? That's a righteous name. You know that, right? That's a good old righteous name. Why do you think that we're in the lowest condition all over the planet Earth?
Because we don't unite, we don't fight for what's right. We are negativity in the state of South Carolina. You gotta put the heart down, sit down, step on the table, and then go understand the ground.
Okay, that's a good point. That's a good point. But according to the history that we're about to bring out today, that I want to show you today, David, I'm going to show you why we're in the condition. We're not just in the condition because we won't unite. There's certain parameters and situations around the reason why we can't unite as a people. Why we see each other as enemies. You understand? Because when I see you, I shouldn't, even though I don't know you, I shouldn't see you as that brother that might get me or that brother that might try to run some game on me. You understand? I should understand that, okay, even though I've never seen David in my life, I know he's still my brother. I gotta have love for you. But we've been taught to hate each other here in this country. Why? Because everything that we've learned since the time we came out of slavery, especially here in Charleston, South Carolina, has been against us. We've learned to hate each other during slavery. Yep. You ever heard of Willie Lynch and the Willie Lynch speech? Willie Lynch is alive and prevalent right here in Charleston, South Carolina, as well as all over the planet Earth today. You understand that? Willie Lynch devised a plan to make the light-skinned slave against the dark-skinned slave, the curly-haired slave against the straight-haired slave. All of these things still take place in our community, and that's the reason for the hatred between one another right now. Because God chose us to be kings on this earth. Did you know that? Give me Deuteronomy 7 and 6. Of course you know that, right? God ordained the so-called black man to be a king on the earth. He ordained the black woman to be a princess on the earth. Did you know that, sister over here walking with your children? Did you know that you have a real God on earth walking with you right now? That young man with you right now is a real God on the earth? If you've never heard that, it behooves you to come and listen to what the Bible says. Because not all these churches around here are going to teach you what we're going to teach you today according to the Bible.
Right.
You have real princesses. You are a real princess. This is a real God walking on God's earth today. All right? Give me Deuteronomy 7 and 6. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 7 verse 6. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
You heard that? Who is God talking to right here? Who is being spoken to in these words of Moses right now? He says that, what? Read it again.
For thou art an holy people.
David, you're a holy people. You're a holy man. Come on.
Unto the Lord thy God.
Unto the Lord thy God, the God of the heavens and earth. Read.
The Lord thy God has chosen thee.
The Lord has chosen you, so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. Come on.
To be a special people.
To be a special people.
Unto himself.
All to himself. Come on.
Above.
Or below.
Above.
Equal to.
Above.
Above.
All people that are upon the face of the earth.
So if God chose you blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians to be a special people above all people on the earth, why is it that you're on the bottom being fed by your oppressor today? Why is it that we stand here in Charleston, South Carolina, in the middle of a park where you have two churches and you don't know that God chose you above all people on the face of the earth? That means you're getting food from a people that is beneath you. That's what this means. You're actually being fed by a people that is beneath you. But let's find out who Moses is talking to in these verses. Let's go to Deuteronomy 1 and 1. Because it's high time we wake up out of sleep. We cannot longer go by the name African American. We will no longer go by the name nigger or accept being called just a nigger, a spick or a coon. We are the gods on this earth here to reclaim our earth starting right here in Charleston, South Carolina today. Read what you got.
Deuteronomy chapter 1 verse 1.
Bring it out.
These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel.
These are the words that Moses spake to all Israel. So this is a clear indication that this Bible, that the words of this Bible are not for everybody. You cannot take this Bible and apply it to everybody. God chose the Israelites. Moses is speaking to the children of Israel. But the question is, who are the children of Israel today? Where are the children of Israel today? I'm going to tell you, they are right here in the midst of these churches being fed by their oppressor. They are right here within the walls of these churches being fed the philosophy, doctrines, and literature of their oppressor.
Right.
All right? We're being taught that Christ is a so-called white man. And we say so-called white because that sister's shirt right there is white. She has on a white shirt. You don't see people walking the earth with looking like that.
Right.
All right? What color is Christ?
Bring it up!
What color is he?
He's a Hebrew.
He was a Hebrew?
Yep.
And he was black? Prove it. How can you prove it?
Where
can I read that at?
Like fire.
You're right. You're exactly right, David. But where can I read that at?
You can read it over in the Hebrew.
I can read it. Let's find out where we can read it at. We can read that Christ was a black man in the book of Revelations.
That's right.
Are they teaching that within these church walls? No. Let's find out what color Christ is. Yes, start at verse 1.
Revelation chapter 1 verse 1.
Turn the speaker down.
The revelation of Jesus Christ.
The revelation of Jesus Christ. This is the revealing of Jesus Christ.
Which God gave unto him to show unto his servants things which must surely come to pass.
So, we're about to reveal what Christ looks like. He gave, read it from the top again. I see these sisters over here listening. Read it from the top again.
The revelation of Jesus Christ.
So we're going to reveal to you today Christ, something that is not being taught in these churches here in Charleston, South Carolina. Come on.
Which God gave unto him.
Which God gave unto John.
To show unto his servant.
We are the servants of God. The Israelites are the true servants of God. Read.
Things which must shortly come to pass. And he said and signified it by his angel unto his servant John. Who bear record.
How do you bear record of something, brother, right here on the bike? How do you bear record of something? If this was the 1300s, 1400s, how do you bear record? How do you do it? This young, you see what he's doing? You write something. Today we record it on phones. You know what I'm saying? We write it in and put it in books. Well, guess what? John wrote something in a book. Let's find out what John wrote about Christ in the book of Revelation.
Verse 14. His head and his hairs were white like wool.
I want you to touch the top of your head, brother. What is your hair like? What is your hair like? Whoa. All right, young man, I want you to rub the top of your head. What does your head feel like? Wool? We're going to prove that Christ is your people, brother. Christ had hair just like you, young man. Young sisters over here. Read it again.
Verse 14. His head and his hairs were what? Like wool.
Christ's head, the meaning the hair on his head and the hairs on his face were white like wool. Come on.
As white as snow.
They were white as snow. What color is your hair turning up top? It's turning white. What about you? And see you, it's white, right? What color is the hairs on your face? The Bible is telling you that Christ had the exact same features. Come on, if you look at this sign right here, this is a depiction of Christ, of what Christ would look like. No, yes, that one at the top. But I'm referring to the one on the end. The one on the end. If Christ walked the earth today, this is a clear depiction of what he would look like if he was on the earth today. Read it from the top again.
His head and his hairs were white like wool, as white as snow.
You see that, young man? It's talking about the hair of his head, just like your hair, and the hairs on his face, because Christ had a full beard. Come on.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
So Christ's eyes were as a flame of fire. Why do you think his eyes were a flame of fire?
My theory?
Yeah. What do you think? Why do you think his eyes were a flame of fire?
Because
He was angry. Christ wasn't. He wasn't a really angry person, but I can see what you're saying.
He was nice in a good way.
But let me ask you this: mm-hmm. What was Christ's first miracle?
What do you make wine to water?
He turned water into wine. What do you do with wine? It was at a feast. What do you do with the wine?
You drink it.
They ain't pour it out. So when you drink wine, what happens? It turned the whites of your eyes turn red. You've been drinking wine. You were drinking. He wasn't drunk. Christ wasn't a drunkard, but he did drink wine. Do you drink wine?
No.
Do you drink? Yes. Yeah, every now and then. See, the whites of your eyes, they're red right now.
I'm blind in this one here.
You blind in that one? Okay. So Christ's eyes was red because he drank wine. Read.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
It said his feet were like fine brass. What color is brass?
Brass
is brown. It's a derivative of brown, right? You agree? You agree? It's a derivative of brown. Come on.
As if they burned in a furnace.
Now, if you take brass and you throw it in a fire, what color does it turn?
It's going to turn different color. It's going to be black.
It's going to be what?
Black.
So, if Christ's feet were bronze, the color of brass, right? Yeah. If they were like brass, meaning bronze or dark brown,
yeah.
And you throw bronze in a fire and it turns black, what color was Christ?
Evidently,
he was a black man, right? Come on, read.
As if they burn in a furnace, and his voice as the sound of many water.
All right, it was a lot of wisdom. So in knowing that Christ, the most powerful man that ever walked on the face of the earth, was a so-called black man, that should make yourself feel a whole lot more proud of yourself than you are. It should make you think, if Christ was the greatest man that walked the earth, and I come from the same direct lineages, why is it that I'm in the condition that I'm in?
Right.
Why are we in the condition that we're in? I'm gonna tell you why. Because we broke the commandments of God and we ended up in a low condition. Let's get Deuteronomy 28. All right? Check. Deuteronomy Deuteronomy 28 is a very important chapter of the Bible, all right? This whole Bible is written only for the children of Israel.
Right.
You are the children of Israel.
That's
you
right.
Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. That's who you are.
Right.
You are not an African American. You are not Negro.
Right.
You're not any of these names and titles right, that you've been called here in America.
Right.
All right? Right? So let's find out why we're in the condition. Do you think the slave ships are in the Bible?
Nope.
Slave ships ain't in the Bible, right? We're going to find out if coming here to Charleston, South Carolina and being put into slavery is in the Bible. But first, we have to figure out why we ended up in the condition that we're in. We got to figure out why we in such a low estate. First, give me Maccabees chapter 3, verse 33, verse 43. Give me that first, because it's very important that you know that we're just not out here for show. We're out here because America's kingdom will end.
That's
every
right.
great kingdom on earth had their rule and they had their destruction. Destruction is coming to America.
Right.
And it's high time that our people, you Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians, realize who you are and come up out of your sins.
That's right.
First Maccabees chapter 3, verse 43. They said one to another, let us restore the decayed estate of our people.
So you're looking at men who have decided to come together to restore the decayed state of our people,
right.
the destroyed mindset of our people. You understand that? We are destroyed as a people. But why is that? That's because we went away from God's laws.
Right.
We stopped keeping God's commandments. And in doing so, we ended up into captivity. Give me Deuteronomy 28, verse 15. Let's find out. Let's go to the most important part of the Bible where the destruction of Israel is prophesied to happen in the Bible. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15.
Bring it up.
But it shall come to pass.
This is a future prophecy that Moses is teaching or telling the children of Israel. After they have been redeemed from Egypt, they've seen all the miracles that God has performed before them. They know that there's a true and living God. Now God has given them laws, statutes, and commandments, prophecies about what's going to happen to them if they go against these commandments. Read.
If thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So it says, if you don't listen to the voice of the Lord thy God, come on.
To observe.
To observe, meaning to pay attention to.
To do.
And to do. It's an action word. You have to be doing God's laws. Come on.
All his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
You hear that, sister? The Bible says that all these curses was going to come upon us and overtake us. Let's find out what some of these curses are. I want to go straight to 32 while the sisters listen. Straight to verse 32. I want to ask you, sister, what is this called? Read.
Verse 32. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
So sister, these are your children, right? If I took your children away from you, violently take your children away from you and give them to another people, like these people here, if I took them and gave them to them, what is that called? What is that called? What is it called? Kidnapping? Is it called kidnapping? It is called kidnapping. But if I took your children and gave them to another people, in ancient times, what do we call this? If these people took your children and put them to work, put them to labor, it was called slavery. Let's read it from the top again. This is the prophecy of the children of Israel going into captivity for breaking God's commandments.
Pray.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 32. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
So God told us, if you break these commandments, your sons and daughters are going to be given to another people. And guess what? Guess where those people were given to, and guess where they ended up at? Right here in Charleston, South Carolina at the port. Right here where they docked the ships. They docked ships right here in what was once known as Charlestown, now called Charleston. This is where you descend from. These are where your children descend from. We are the true children of the slave trade.
Right,
not
right.
Everyone can claim this curse. They can say, oh, this fits the such and such people and this fits this people. No, the curses of this Bible only pertain and fit to a certain group of people.
Right.
Read on.
And thine eyes shall look and fell with longing for them all the day long.
God says when your children are taken away from you, you're going to look and see them being taken away from you, and you're going to be crying. And there's nothing you're going to be able to do. There's not going to be no power in your hand. You got to have no military. There's nothing you're going to be able to do to redeem your children back from your oppressor, back from your enemy. That took place right here in Charleston, South Carolina. A few blocks away from here, you have old slave plantations where you can go and look at the history of your forefathers. You better believe today, your brothers stand before you telling you, you're not just a slave, you're not just a nigga, you are the Israelites, God's chosen people, according to the Bible. That is who you are. You are God on this earth, young man. You are a princess. And it's high time you wake up and realize that. Give me that in Revelation 13 real quick. We're coming back to Deuteronomy. Because it is important for our people to understand that you wake up. It is important that you know that you have to keep God's laws. This is the reason for us being in this condition. We broke the commandments. We got to come back to keeping God's commandments if we want our condition to ever change.
Right.
This is not going to give us change. They can bring food to our community for the next 100 years. Guess what? As long as you're in the same condition and they're on top, they cool with that.
Romans chapter 13, verse 11. And that, knowing the time.
And that knowing the time, sister, we look out into the world today, we see all this destruction taking place on earth. We see countries going to war. We see testing being done with nuclear missiles. What do you think these things are for? Read it again.
And that, knowing the time.
And that, knowing the time.
That now it is high time to awake out of sleep.
Now it is high time to awake out of that sleep that we've been walking in for over 400 years after slavery in this country. Come on.
For now is our salvation nearer than when we believe.
For now our salvation is nearer than we ever believe. You've always heard your grandmother say, we're living in the last days. You've always heard your mama say, we're living in the last days. Well, guess what? You see men of God rising up to come teach you and tell you that we are now in the midst of destruction of America. If you want to be saved here in America, you must be doing God's commandments. Without these commandments, destruction is coming to your front door.
Daniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.